Welcome to Go Live TV, the future in your hands. The only multicultural IPTV station that brings communities together. Over 2.7 million people have already watched. Go Live TV, anytime, anywhere.
Connect with God's anointed, Apostle Richard Quaco Parker, the voice of Toronto, the international preacher, a voice raised by God in this end time. This and every Tuesday, 3 p.m. to 3:30 p.m., live on Go Live TV. It's Miracle Touch Hour, a time of encounter, open heaven, pure word impact and manifestation of the power of God.
Voice of the enemy is broken now in the mighty name of Jesus. I am under the Holy Ghost now. I decree my...
Contact the man of God, the intercessor raised to stand in the gap by phone or WhatsApp 416-509-2833 by email richie1obi@gmail.com or by web at www.wordbasedchapel.org.
God bless you wherever you are, ladies and gentlemen. Do me a favor, invite somebody to connect this hour, because something is about to happen. There's going to be a prophetic move of God. It's going to be a prophetic, release this afternoon. Hallelujah. Because I've been mandated by God to come on your way at this hour entitled Miracle Touch Hour. This is an hour that one needs to believe and activate your spirit for something great to come on your way. Are you understand what I'm talking about? Before I proceed, let's have a word of prayer. Father, thank you in Jesus' name. May your name be exalted. May your name be praised. I pray that give me the audacity and release the warrant, the prophetic warrant for me to speak your word and to break every satanic powers of the enemy. Are you in the name of Jesus? I pray that, Father, let the unseen to found seen be released. I pray against any obstacles breaking every evil. And I pray that let those who have been oppressed by the enemy be set loose. Let anyone under bondage, oh God, let him or her be freed by divine power of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you. And I give all the praise in Jesus' name. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Beloved, God is good and his mercies endure forever. I want you to know that, you know, God on your side, you are, there's a victory assured. Are you understand what I'm talking about? David said, in all that day, when I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I fear no evil. Once you have God on your side, you are not scared of evil. You are not afraid of any turbulence and any threatenings of the wicked, because you know that God Almighty, Yahweh Adonai, Jehovah Rapha, El Elyon, El Shammah, is with you. So you are not scared. You are not moved. Hallelujah. So may God bless you in Jesus' name for connecting. Share it and invite others to come, because there's no distance in the realms of the spirit. Once you are connected, you become the beneficiary of the anointing. I've been anointed by God to come on your way to announce to you that this is your time of divine elevation, time of divine favor, time of divine exposure in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Somebody say, talk to me. Oh my God. Beloved, I want to pray for you. Let me pray before I proceed. I want to pray for you, whoever you are watching me, that the Lord would hold your hands and your family to cross the year 2021 to the year 2022. Can I hear amen? Oh my God. If you believe it, shall I hear you? You will cross over to the coming year in the mighty name of Jesus. There will never be any records of untimely death. Oh my God, you are not here with me. There shall never be any record of untimely death in your family, because the power of God is about to move as never before in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Speak the word is the word that God have given to me. Speak the word. In every situation, you got to exercise faith and speak to the situation. Nothing changes if you don't speak to it. You see, there's a way. We, the people of God, oh my God, in the kingdom of God, there's a way we approach things. Our approach and our laid down procedure is different from those who are in the world. So those who are in the world, there are things they must do before they can get their daily bread. Are you getting what I'm talking about? But for us, the Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and its righteousness, and every other thing shall be added unto us. So the way somebody in the world has to do to get money, it's a different way I have to do. Are you understanding what I'm talking about? Because my government that I am that's the government of God. The Bible says when you pray and said, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us our daily bread. Oh my God, man, di mahataya. In this kingdom, there's a provision. In the kingdom of God, there's a daily provision and daily release and daily favor. So once you are in this government, no matter how pandemic will come, it will never affect you because you are not of this world. You are under divine protection of God in Jesus' name. Somebody say, talk to me. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Yes, I love the sound. I love this sound. Amen. I need this sound. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Now, help me. We're going to move in higher altitude. So wherever you are, let somebody connect that. Listen to Go Live. My God, a place where anointing is moving, where God have ordained the place to reach out his people. So call and invite others to connect so that you and I will be blessed. Somebody shall hear you. Now, do you know that in every situation you find yourself, you have the power to change that situation. You have the power. You have the power. And I'm going to teach you some principles in the kingdom and how you can able to change situation by spoken word. By spoken word. The Bible says in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was without form and voidless. And the Bible says darkness was upon the face of the waters, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, let there be light. So there is power in spoken words. And the Bible said light came because the light was in the word of the words of God. So without the word, nothing good can come out. So God said, let there be light, and light came. So there's something in your word. The Bible said that let us create man in our own image and our likeness. So we have something in us. That's why the book of Proverbs chapter 18, the verse 20 to 21, he said that he who that love his lips shall eat the fruit thereof. And he said, life and death lies in the power of the tongue, and he who that love it shall eat the fruit thereby. So there's life in your tongue, and there is death in your tongue. That is why you must not say that you die. That's why you must refuse any negative word. One of the things the enemy does is that he will use your own words to fight you. Bible said a man shall be justified by his own words, and man shall be condemned by his own words. So when you wake up in the morning, what you need to do is to declare and say, no weapon formed against me shall prosper, and any tongue that lifted against me shall be condemned. You got to speak the word over your life, because words are powerful and words are spirit. Are you understanding what I'm talking about? I don't know the situation you find yourself, but speak the word of God into that situation. The only language the devil understands is the word of God. Are you understanding what I'm talking about? The enemy cannot bow down when you speak good English. The devil cannot control to your poho when you can put sentences together, or you have the PAD and have big money in your account. The enemy only respond and can control or bow down to you is when you exercise the authority that is in Christ Jesus by speaking the word and said, I have overcome you by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. That is how you can able to overcome the devil. If somebody hear me, if you can hear me, shout, I hear you. Am I blessing somebody out there? I'm not here to lecture you. I don't know how to lecture. I'm not a lecturer. I am a voice. I am an anti-militant voice. Raised and prepared in the wilderness. Trained by God in the wilderness. And released to proclaim the word of God. So speak to the situation. Speak to it. Life is in your mouth. It is in your tongue, and death is in your tongue. Don't say that you can't make it. Don't say that you'll die. Don't say that because of corona, wherever, your business will collapse. Say no, in this time, you will rise to the top. Declare to yourself that as for me, goodness and mercy shall follow me. Declare to yourself that as for me, my family are secure and protected. As for me and my family, we are under the shelter of God. Speak the word, and so shall it be. Are you hearing my voice? If you can hear me, shall I hear you? There's power in your word. Change your situation by speaking to it. Change that situation. If you say you will die, you will die. If you say you are poor, so you are. The Bible said that when they came to Moses, the 10 men said to Moses, and said, Moses, we see ourselves like grasshoppers, and we are unable to go and possess the land because we saw the giant on the land. So when they said that word, in their mindset, they cannot go for the land. In their mindset, they have been defeated. But glory be to God that there was a man anointed by God called Caleb. We need men that are anointed by God. We need pastors that are anointed by God. We need men of God that are anointed by God that can come to the situation and speak and challenge the words of the enemy. We are tired of book loans and all kind of material in the ministry. We want to engage ourselves with power. So when Caleb came to the scene, he said that no, this day man out of the spirit, they are speaking out of the flesh. The Lord has promised us, oh my God, the Lord has said to us that the land in which we are in belongs to us, so we are able. Oh my God, I came to announce to somebody, you are able. Oh my God, it doesn't matter the season that you are in, you are able, you are able, you are able. In order that Paul said, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Oh my God, if you have Christ on your side, it doesn't matter how difficult the situation is. It doesn't matter the economy in which you are in. You got to exercise power and declare that as for you, you no beg for bread. As for you, nothing can able to bring you down. Can I declare to somebody that you are watching me now, I speak the word of God over your life, that the Lord will keep you safe from every evil. May the Lord keep our family, our home safe from every evil. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, may the Lord keep the gold life viewers safe in the name of Jesus. May the Lord keep anyone that's watching me safe in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In other day, when there was economic crisis in Samaria, the Bible said that all hope was gone and people were just waiting for time to die, and they came a man anointed by God, somebody that have received the anointing. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the anointing. Oh, I'm telling you, the work of God is all about the anointing. It's the anointing that breaks the yoke. That's what the Bible says. Look at how Jesus Christ, oh my God, was anointed with power and Holy Ghost, who went about doing good and healing the sick, because God was with him. I am anointed this afternoon, and I decree in the name of the Lord, I don't know what you are going through, but in the name of Jesus Christ, receive your healing now, receive your touch now, receive your deliverance in the mighty name of the Lord. So Elijah said, hear ye the word of God. Elijah spoke the word and said, tomorrow by this time there will be food in Samaria. I decree in the name of the Lord, my sister, you not die in this pandemic. The news out there is saying that You have so many sickness coming. So, but I decree by the word of the Lord, no evil can befall us. Oh my God. No evil can befall your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, whose reports are you believe? Believe the reports of the Lord. For he you that is with us is able. Is somebody hearing the sound of my voice? If you can hear me, shout, I hear you. Alala bandi bada. Azimbagu Zahaya. There's a financial favor right now. Doors are open in the name of the Lord. On Sunday, there was a young woman that came to church and said, man of God, in the days where people are losing their jobs, where people have been sacked from jobs, I have been promoted. Oh my God. You see, when the anointing is working, it doesn't matter how things are working in this world, because the grace is sufficient. And the lady testified to God, ladies and gentlemen, there is a name above every other name. That name is Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. If you can speak to that situation, you see the miracle of God, you see the power of God. I remember in the book of Mark chapter 4, the verse 39, a message was sent to Jesus Christ that a soldier's son was sick and about to die. The Bible says that when they send the word to Jesus, the man said, no, Jesus, you don't need to come to my home. I am a man under authority. I believe our words are powerful. I believe our words are powerful. You just speak the word, and my servant will be made whole. I dare stand by the power. I see people all over the world. Maybe you are watching me at America, in Africa, Asia, Europe. I release the word of God unto your life. That situation that you are going through, that announcement that you have heard that you are about to die, that thing that is troubling your life, now it is over now. It is over. It is over. I am under the unction of God, and I decree and declare, you are out from that mess now. You are out of that mess now. God is telling that mess for a message. He's telling the trial to triumph in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. For I, the servant of God, I see miracle coming to you. I see favor coming to you. Can I declare? Can I speak a word? Sister, wherever you are, speak the word to yourself. Say that you will not die. Prophesy. Declare that the Lord is on your side. Oh, declare that longevity is your portion. Richard Kukupaka, the voice of the city of Toronto, the international preacher, the man who doesn't know how to preach sermons but only deliver messages. I decree in the name of the Lord, the words I hear my voice, I stand in go live. The time is coming, the time is now, where my voice shall be heard in all over the world, where cripples shall walk under my ministry, where blind shall see in the name of the Lord. Speak the word, it shall come to pass. Declare it in the name of the Lord. Don't be afraid. Speak it, speak it. Speak to the situation. Miracle is taking place now. Speak into your marriage. Maybe your marriage is at the edge of collapsing. Say, my marriage will not die. My marriage is resurrecting back again. You are going through financial challenges. Speak to the financial challenges now and say that my account is increasing. By faith, it shall come to pass. I'm not here to tell you stories of men. I believe and I know that no Jesus Christ, he the same yesterday, today, and forever. The Bible said the other day, when Jesus Christ was in the boat with the disciples, there came the storm to trouble the journey, to trouble them on the way. The Bible said Peter and co, they did whatsoever they could do, but nothing came out from whatever they did. Their human effort could not solve the problem. There are certain things that you need the supernatural. There's certain situations you need the power. There's certain things, my sister, you need to have encounter with the anointing of God. So the Bible said, Jesus Christ rose up and said, peace be still. And the Bible said the wind stopped and the sea became calm. Ladies and gentlemen, the only thing that you and I need is to speak to the situation. I am blessed. I've been saying I'm the voice of the city. And so as I've become, when I was saying that I am international preacher, when I was in Africa, people were saying to me that you have never traveled before. Why do you call yourself international preacher? But my words have come to pass. Anything that you keep on saying, if you become, oh my God, you become, I am a billionaire. I am somebody raised by God. My God, nations are bound to me. I don't care how you understand it. I don't care how you fight it. One thing that I know, life and death is in the power of my tongue. Oh my God, can I declare? I feel the anointing of God right now. Canada is blessed in the name of Jesus. Go Live TV is going everywhere. Go Live TV is going everywhere. There is anointing affecting the land of Canada. Peoples are walking now in the mighty name of the Lord. Nobody shall die before your time. I decree in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Any sickness that is in the atmosphere, Canada is exempted. Canada is exempted. Our homes, we are exempted in the mighty name of the Lord. Say, I am exempted. Declare wherever you are. Begin to pray. Join me in prayer. Say, I am exempted in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. For it is written in the book of Psalm 91, the verse 10. For there shall no plague come to your dwelling, and there shall no harm come to you. I decree in the name of Jesus, no harm, 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 no calamity, no harm come before me, no harm come before you, no harm, no harm, no plague come before me and my children, come before your life. Can I declare, sister, pray, be on your feet wherever you are, begin to pray now, something is taking place in the mighty name of the Lord. Maybe you are hearing me in the hospital. Miracle is coming now. No plague, no plague, no plague. Aye, babe, babe. Abim bali wakemba. Azim baga degata. Abam bam bam ba. Alibru kimba kidiga. Azambri katumbri kata. In the mighty name of Jesus, speak the word and so shall it come to pass. Don't be afraid. The Bible says he sent forth his word and his word healed them. I'm sending the word of God that my sister, it is well. I'm sending the word of God to somebody that you've lost your business. Your business has collapsed. Hear me. The Bible says in the book of Joel chapter 2, the verse 28, that all the Lord shall restore all the year the locusts have eaten. There's a restoration now. There's a restoration now. There's a restoration now. There's a restoration now. Your business is coming back again. Your business coming back again. In the mighty name of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Speak to the situation and you shall see miracle. Oh, yes, Lord. Kabahata. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Oh, Jesus. Labanto Mahataya. John chapter 6, verse 66. Oh my God, if we're blessed, if we're blessed with this ministry and you want to sow to the ministry, you can follow the link and bless the Lord. Hallelujah. We want to shake up, you know, prayer in the system. We want to awake people to stand for the word. I'm telling you, the Bible says heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word will never pass away. My word will never pass away. My word, I hear an amen. Before the foundation of this world, the word of God is settled. So it is too late. Nobody can bring you down. Whatsoever they are doing, it is working for your good. Oh my God. So much, it is working for my good. Can I? Oh my God. Those who have joined me, just say it is working for my good. Just say it for me. Say it is working for my good. Just say it is working for my good. It is working for your good. Share it and invite others. It is working for your good. Because from the beginning of the world, whatsoever God have destined you to become, it is done already. So means it is too late. Speak to the situation. He said, the word that I speak, their life and their power. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I don't know the situation you are going through, my sister. I don't know the kind of battle you are going through. But there is a name that's above every other name. The Bible says there was a man that was placed at a beautiful gate to ask of arms, and nobody spoke a word to him. But they came men of prayer. They came people who know their God, who believe their God, who have had encounter with the Holy Ghost. I've been saying, without the Holy Spirit, you are not a preacher. Everybody can preach, but without the Holy Ghost, you cannot preach about Christ. No. Without the Holy Ghost, he said, wait until thou have been empowered with the Spirit. And when the Spirit comes, you'll be my witness. So there's a difference between people speaking, and there's a difference between somebody that's baptized with the Holy Ghost. Because with the Holy Ghost, miracle is in these signs. So where if there's no signs, then your message is not from God. Because God back his word with signs and wonders. So wherever you are not poor. Somebody say I'm not poor. When Bay Chapel, we are believing God to acquire a bigger space. Man. There's no money, but we decree by divine answer that money has been released. We are not. Somebody say, I'm not poor. Challenge, speak to the situation. Don't let the situation speak to you. Speak to it. Declare. God is moving us to a bigger space. Where, oh my God, where thousands of people will come and have engagement with the power. I'm telling you. When Elijah said tomorrow by this time, the word moved into the atmosphere. Certain availability person to work through him or her to fulfill the prophecy. Mama, you are a vessel of Christ. You are a vessel. Sister Alice, those who are watching me, you are a vessel of financial favor. Sister Alice, God has blessed you. You are watching me in the United States. You are blessed. It doesn't matter. And I know you support the work of God. I know. Sister Gasglo Dubias, may God bless you. My God. My wife, may God bless you wherever you are. You are blessed. Declare that your children are blessed. I am blessed. I am not poor. I will live long. In the name of Jesus, I possess the land. I take authority over the finance, over the gold, over the riches. Declare, don't speak evil, because whatsoever you say, there's a saying, sir. When the police arrest somebody, there's a particular statement that police always say, and I believe that word. They'll say, you have all means to be silenced, or else anything that you say shall be used against you at the court of the law. So I will never say I am broke so that they will use it to make me broke. I will say I am rich, because the Bible says, let the poor say I am rich, and let the weak say I am strong. Speak to it. What the chapel, we shall fly higher. This ministry will affect life in Canada, Toronto. My ministry will affect the land of Canada. It will bless cities in the name of Jesus. Anything that we will do, it shall prosper. No failure on our way. And no enchantment can bring the ministry down. For God said, I will build my church, and the gate of hell cannot prevail. Whatsoever they are doing, let it return back to the sender. Someone say, back to the sender. He said, speak your word, it shall not stand. Take counsel together, it shall be broken to pieces. Because God is on our side. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. I came to announce to you that speak to your situation. Somebody financial doors open for you. Somebody financial doors open. A job will be calling for you. I'm telling you. A job will be begging you. There's another man in our ministry. He's a man of God. Even in the pandemic that where people are losing their job, I was being invited and said, tell us how much you want and we'll pay you. Mama, I decree in the name of the Lord, you will never go dry. You will never be, you can't be cursed. You will never beg. The Lord will see us through. I said, the Lord will see us through. The Lord will see us through. The Lord will see you through. The Lord will see you through. I know you are listening to me. God will see you through. If you have been touched to support the work of God for us to acquire a bigger space, pick the information, pick the number, 416-509-2833. If you are looking for a place to pray, a place where you can grow in this country, call this number, we'll pray with you. Hallelujah. We'll stand with you in prayer. And if you want to sow willingly, not by force, willingly, you can do so in Jesus' name. I believe in a free will offering. I believe it. And I know somebody's heart has been touched. I know that somebody's heart has been touched. May God bless you all once again. This is Apostle Richard Kweku Parker, the voice of the city of Toronto. This is Miracle Touch Hour every Tuesday, 5 to 5:30. I'll be coming on your way on Go Live TV. Please share the station, support the station. Go Live TV, support it. Tell people about this television. We are all over the world now. You can set us in every area. May God bless you. We salute Mr. Junalo and the family. We pray for you. And I decree in the name of Jesus Christ that the Lord who have begun with you, he will take you to places. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for viewers out there. May the Lord be with you in Jesus' name. Connect and you'll be blessed. I love you. In Jesus' name, once again, I am the apostle, the voice of Toronto, the international preacher. We are located at 95 Eddystone Avenue, Unit 5, the name of the church, West Bay Chapel Ministries. Oh my God, hallelujah. Join the eagles to fly. We love you. God bless you all. Stay blessed. Amen.
By the Holy Spirit. Jesus clearly said to Peter, you could not have known